It is lecture number 18, and here we will talk about further example on linear model, various other perspectives. So now onward you will see the real feeling of linear model, how and what are the real application of those things. So those things we will see it here. So coming to outline of my today's lecture, first I would like to discuss about univariate simple linear regression. It is the simplest linear model what we have till now seen that. We will see that. And if you are going to model from data, if you try to learn from the data, then you can say that it is one kind of hello world. Linear simple univariate linear regression, it is a hello world. That means if you know this one, then that means you have already started learning that, learning from data. So that is the perspective. So you have to be very good in that, how it is doing all those modeling perspective or things, and what are the insight of those things we need to know. So I will talk various simple type of question. Definitely those would be simple, but having a very deep meaning. And after that, once we will cover this one, I will talk about univariate multiple linear regression. Simple, I had already told that there is a single attribute, and univariate is talking about a single response. So that is the thing. Now we will complicate it a little bit. That means in place of single attribute, we will go for multiple attribute, and the response would remain single response. So that kind of things we will discuss these things. Okay, so coming to first part that of this lecture, that univariate simple linear regression, before going to that, I would like to talk further about relation between estimator of a random variable. So those things, then I will take one example. Okay, so consider we are taking any kind of what we call it observation with which include two component. One component that we are calling it signal, another component we are calling it noise, additive noise. Addition, with addition it is coming additive noise. If with multiplication it will come, then we will call it multiplicative noise. So this one is generally we are having additive noise because source of that might be something else. Okay, so we will see that we need to calculate the variance of this one. So definitely variance can be expressed as an estimator of this x, least square estimator of this one, this x, and this so least square estimator of this would be what we know, that this x will have a least square estimator thanks to the observation y. So this would be the least square estimate of this x under the observation y. And we know that if we are talking about this one, so also better, why not we express the variance of, we try to find the variance of x in term of those things. So I'm just trying to express variance of x. So just go blindly, take definition of the variance. What does it say? It is talking about expectation of a square of mean deviation. So that it is directly coming from the definition of the variance of x. So what we do here, we do little bit computation or manipulation. So what we do here, we are adding and subtracting the least square estimate of x given y. So this is the, so we are adding here and subtracting. So that's why we are getting this pattern. And further, if you try to bifurcate it, simplify it further, it will be bifurcated into two parts. One part is this one and another part is this one. So just try to look into this. What does it talk about? What is this one? Anyone would like to suggest? What is the name of this? No idea. Here what? This one is expectation of x, and this one is expectation, conditional expectation. So conditional expectation is what? It is a random variable, and from the law of iterated expectation, we know that expectation of conditional expectation is equal to expectation of that variable. So we can say that this quantity is the expectation of this random variable. So we can say that this quantity is what? It is talking about a square of mean deviation of this random variable. Okay, so simply we can say that it is talking about variance of conditional expectation. And what is this one? If you try to focus this one, so it is what? This one is the estimation of x, this one is original that we want to estimate, that that signal. Okay, so what is name of this? Anyone, do you know the name of this? Anyone? Sara? What is that x minus conditional expectation of x given y? Any other? Aditi? Yes, yes, sir. Just try to answer. Do you know it or not? Okay, if you are facing any problem, there is a very simple meaning. I always say that it is conditional expectation of x given y. It is talking about least square estimation of x, least square estimate of x. So definitely it is an estimate, and this one is the original one that we don't know. So the difference if you take from the original one, this we will call it error. What is this one? Error. So you can give a short name. Definitely it would be also a random variable e. If you talk about, I am giving one more homework, find the mean of error, this error term here, or prediction error. Simply, what is the name of this one? Prediction error. That means x minus, it is your homework. I have already derived several times, but here again you need to derive it for a better understanding. The mean of this prediction error. E is defined like this way. I will call it prediction. It is x minus that conditional expectation of x given y. So find this one. What would be this one? If you directly, someone know the derivation of expectation, then easily can answer this one. One line answer is there. Anyone? What would be expectation of prediction error? Anyone would like to comment over it? It is just zero, because if you are applying expectation over this prediction error, it would become expectation of x, and it would becomes what, a law of iterated expectation. From there it again become expectation of x, and hence expectation of x minus expectation of x is what, zero. So that's why expectation of prediction error is always zero. Now another term, if you talk about, if it is zero, so you can replace it here. What is the prediction error? Is now it is a random variable. You can say that mean of that is zero. So this quantity minus zero square. So what does it define? It defines variation of the prediction error. Variation of the prediction error. So this, that means variance of any signal can be bifurcated into in term of estimated kind of things. So one is variance of conditional expectation, that means least square estimator, plus variance of the prediction error. So that bifurcation you need to know for any linear model. Okay, see the observed random variable y. Here we will try why I have bifurcated in this way. We will try to see the when y, that observation y is when meaningful or when it is not meaningful. See the observed random variable y, it is informative if and only if the mean square prediction error, this one is just, this quantity is just equal to variance of the prediction error. This how we define. So this mean square prediction error. See, mean square. This is the prediction error. Mean square. So it is what, variance of the, what we call it. It is just equal to variance of the, what we simply see, we say that if you try to find, it is variance of prediction error equal to, we are defined like this way. And as, when it would be this, it simply says that variance of conditional expectation is equal to zero. So this will signify variance of conditional expectation is equal, but it is equal to zero. No, otherwise you can leave it like this way. Leave it right now. What you do? Take simple variance of, if variance of conditional expectation is equal to zero, it will imply that what? It is a fixed constant number. But if you are taking a constant number, that one is always having a zero variance. So if you are taking variance of conditional expectation is equal to zero, this this quantity you are making it zero. So that means what is here? I would like to write it like this way. We are taking variance of x equal to variance of prediction error. If you are taking assumption in such a way, variance of x is equal to variance of prediction error, then in that case it implies that variance of this quantity would be zero. Variance of conditional expectation would be zero, and it implies that this quantity is a constant number. And what is that constant? That constant is actually expectation of x. And why? Because here, despite of observing y first, it is not giving any information regarding x. So in that case, this is the situation of uninformative nature of y. Despite of observing y, it is not going to give any fruitful thing about x. So it will. So another, this one is one scenario. Another scenario is that suppose you are having two random variable x and y, and y you are observing, and from the observation of y you try to estimate x, then whether it is meaningful or not. It would be meaningless if x and y are independent. If x and y are independent, then it will be meaningless. That means information of having y, the observed value of y, is not going to talk about anything about x. So why? Because in the same situation we will have, because x and y are independent to each other, so conditional expectation of x given y, it would be just equal to expectation of x, because observation of y is not giving any information about x. There is no dependency. So that's why y is also here indeed in or uninformative. So in both case, one case is this one. That means when the variance of x is equal to variance of prediction error, or in short, you can say that variance of what we call it conditional expectation is equal to zero. That is the situation. That situation leads to uninformative nature of y. Another situation, that independency between x and y, that also leads to uninformative nature of y. So this is the further criterion for linear model. Now for further, we will take one example here, univariate simple linear regression. This, after that I will talk about generalization of this concept. Okay, so consider an example, like a student in mathematics class taught by one of the several authors, okay, or several teacher, or simply you can take only one teacher is teaching here in this scenario, claim that doing the homework had not help prepare them for the midterm. So a student are claiming that what if they are doing homework, that one is not helping midterm. So whether the student are they are true or false, so that we will see through linear regression, simple linear regression. We will have only two kind of only one attribute and one response. The response is that it is related with midterm mark, and the attribute would be homework, marks in homework. So x would be related with homework marks, and y response, it would be related with midterm marks. That response we will see that. Then data is given here like this way. So the exam score, the midterm exam score y, and homework exam score x. So suppose midterm exam means midterm exam, call it midterm exam score is y, and homework score is x. Okay, average up to the time of midterm. Up to the time of midterm, homework, it is a continuous process. You might be aware of that. So for the 18 student in the class, the data is given like this way. So for 18 student, for first student, suppose midterm mark is 95 and homework mark is total homework. That means several homework would be there. So we have aggregated to single by taking average up. So this x is average mark of all those homework that you got till midterm. So these are the average homework marks till midterm. And so how many 18 students? So due to a space problem, I have taken it in three column of y and three column of x. So in order, total 18 students are there. Okay, and all this is the data. So we try to see the dependency of y on x. So y is your midterm mass, whether it is having a dependency over x or not. So in that perspective, we try to learn a function f, and in such a way that will talk about dependency of y over x. So we will take a linear approach, linearly very simple kind of model that we will take it, omega naught plus omega 1 x. So this model we will take. So this model we will call it, it is a linear function in the parameter. So that's why it is a linear, and it is a simple, that means there is only one attribute, that one is that average homework score, and what we do. So I will ask few more things. So if you try to estimate, able to estimate this one omega naught and omega 1, that will give estimated value of this model f cap, you can say that f cap. Or how we came across to this model? So it is simply we tried to find an approximation of conditional expectation, that means y given x here. Okay, slide is visible or not? Anyone? So I was in the last slide. Okay. Phew. So here I was talking about that given problem. We need to estimate y for given x. So we take a very simple kind of linear approximation of this conditional expectation, omega naught plus omega 1 time x. Okay, and we know the derivation. So this is the linear model that we have taken. So we know the previous least square estimation of the parameter omega naught and omega 1. What was that? Omega 1, the estimate of omega 1, it is what? Omega 1 cap, it is what? It is the ratio of covariance between x and y. X is the thing that the given to you, that observation, x is the observation, and y that we want to predict or we want to estimate. So that is the, so it is directly this, it is second moment, it is coming with respect to second moment, that means it is estimate of covariance of x with y, and this one is the estimate of what we call it. It is estimate, so approximation you can put it. So estimate, and it is the approximate estimate of variance of x. So variance of x, it would be, so we did estimation and we are having all the data. We are having xi, we are having x bar, that means sample mean, we are having yi and we are having y bar. So we can calculate this one. This one is already computable. It is computable and I have taken already. What you do when you are having data, what always convert that as a CSV file, or always otherwise you can put in Excel. So it is very easy to compute x bar, y bar. Excel is already very much feasible with all the mathematic calculations. So that's why put the data there for what to faster approach. So I have taken, and these are the x, these are the y, and I deviated by mean. Also I calculated mean of x, this is the sample mean of x, this was, this is the sample mean of y, 61.3889 and 58.05, this is the sample mean of x. So we deviated x by the corresponding mean, that means it is what, x minus sample mean x bar. This fourth column, it is talking about deviation of y by corresponding mean, that means y minus y bar. And third one is talking about what, product of mean deviation of x and y. So it is product, and this one is for calculation of variance of x, estimation of variance, not calculation of variance of x, because we are having just sample, we are not having complete data, we are having sample. So that's why I should not call it this one is the variance, it is just estimation of variance. So one estimate we can calculate. So you gather all these things and sum in the numerator, it is containing the sum of this term. Sum is coming 17,043.61, and in lower we see that sum varies from 1 to n. At n is here 18. You can count it here. N is equal to 18. Just calculate, then in total you are having ratio of this quantity divided by 19,530.95. If you simplify, you are getting the value of one estimated value of omega 1 that we denoted omega 1 hat, and that value is 0.872. And by using this value you can calculate the value of omega naught hat. That one is just, you are having this value, you have already calculated omega 1 hat, and you are having value sample mean of x from the data, given data. So omega naught hat is 10.73. So what you got? You got one estimate of this conditional expectation of pi given x, this linear model. This is the estimate of linear model, and it is giving like this way. So you are having a model, it is a linear model, and it can be seen like this way. If someone is saying that, here one more thing, that this is an estimate of conditional expectation, this model y given x, and we say that this conditional expectation is a estimate of y. So simply you can say that, if you can't say that the y cap is a estimate of y, y cap is not an estimate of y. Don't be confused with that. Y cap is not an estimate of y. It is not like that directly. What actually, first we need to find some estimator of y. So estimator of y is what? Conditional expectation of y given x. Then this one is having very complex form. We don't know what form it would be. It depends upon the distribution of x and y. If you know the distribution of x and y, and if it happens to be Gaussian, then we can easily say that it will be linear. But we don't know the distribution of x and y. We don't know. We know the distribution of x here. What is the distribution of x? Data is coming like this way. Anyone can say that? What is the distribution of x? Then x is behaving like a constant. So distribution of x is very simple. It is uniform distribution. It would be 1 by 18. Probability mass function for x would be 1 by 18. So we know that. But what is the distribution of x? We don't know. It depends highly on the error term what you are taking here. Y equal to this quantity. That means least square estimation of y given x plus error term is coming. Error term. So if someone is saying that you know that it is very much uniform in nature, then you need to know the distribution of y. Either you know the distribution of y, or explicitly you know the distribution of y, then it would be okay. There would be no issue. So here you don't know the distribution of y. Why? Because you don't know the distribution of this error term. So from that perspective, we can say that we are taking a linearization concept of conditional expectation, that regression function. So we consider this regression function one linear approximation of this one. So this is the linear approximation. So here y hat, that means it is defined like this way, omega naught hat plus omega 1 hat x, it is talking about estimation of the regression function. And directly it is not talking about the estimation of y, it is talking about estimation of the regression function. And after that, we know that regression function happens to be least square estimate of y. Y can have various estimate, least square estimate, maximum likelihood estimate, then map, various, there are several, you can see that. So that's where you directly can't say that it estimate y, actually just it and this y cap estimate the regression function. Okay, that is the approach. And that plot you may see here. So I will talk about general theory for simple linear univariate regression. Yeah, you can say that univariate simple linear regression. So how you can introduce it like this way? So I will deviate a little bit from the what we call it a random variable approach. I'm directly going towards statistics. So previously what I had discussed, I discussed from probabilistic point of view. Now I'm going towards more towards statistics. Okay, that is the approach. So simple linear regression model for n observation. So we are taking n observation, n number of sample sizes, and simply we can say that it can be written as like this way: yi equal to omega naught plus omega 1 xi plus error term epsilon i. Okay, for n number of observation, that means sample size is n, a number of observation that I had already mentioned. Now we assume here, what assume? We assume that yi and epsilon i both are random in nature. They are random, they are having some distribution. Random simply that means they are not constant. Yi and epsilon i, but what does it mean? They are having other than uniform distribution. So that is the meaning. Okay, and the value of xi are constant, non-constant. We know about that. What is meaning of that? Constant means simply they are having constant protein mass function. That means they are having uniform distribution. Simply you can say that constant meaning of that. If someone is saying that I have taken three constant, 1, 2, 3, then if I ask what is the distribution of this, anyone can say that what is the distribution of this, what is the protein mass function of this observed value? If x is observing this value, what is the protein mass function for this? Anyone? Just think and try to answer it. What is the distribution of 1, 2, 3? Anyone know this? Just try to answer it. It is very simple kind of question. Janit? No. This one is 1. Protein mass function for this one would be 1 by 3. Because no assumption is given here. By default, what kind of equally likely situation you have to take it. So the distribution would be, the protein mass function would be 1 by 3. So likewise, x i is a constant, and if it is taking n number of values, x i, there are n number of values, because n number of sample you have taken. So that's why it is a constant. Why? Because it is having a distribution 1 by n due to equally likely situation. Would be okay. So in order to further model this problem, we have to make few more additional assumptions over, because we don't know the distribution of yi and epsilon i. So we have to make further assumption over these two. Okay, and xi is a constant, equally likely situation, that n number of xi we have already observed. Now we, what assumption we are making? First assumption we are making that the expectation of this error term epsilon i is always zero, because it is very much related with prediction error, and we had already seen that the expectation of prediction error, that means if we are going to estimate y for given observation, given observation x, then we had already seen that if you try to find the expectations of this one from the law of iterated expectation, it will come to equal to zero. So that's where this one is error and this one is prediction error. So if prediction error is having expectation zero, so that's why we are also assuming that the actual error, what it would be in that model, that would also having zero expectation for every sample. Equivalently, we can say that if you apply expectation both side over this model, this linear model, then we know that we have taken expectation of epsilon I equal to zero, and it will imply that expectation of yi is just equal to this constant number omega naught plus omega 1 xi. This is the, so this one is implies this one, and vice versa, both implies to each other. Second assumption we are taking, that variance of epsilon I is equal to sigma square, and it will imply that variance of yi would be also equal to sigma square, because this one is a constant. Constant is having zero variance. If you try to find, if you take any constant, that would be zero, that would have zero variance. Third assumption we are taking, that if you take further condition over this error term epsilon i, if any two epsilon I are uncorrelated, any two epsilon I epsilon j uncorrelated, that also implies that the corresponding response yi yj, it would be uncorrelated. That means if covariance between ii epsilon I epsilon j is zero, it implies that covariance between yi and yj is also zero. So these three assumptions we are taking for modeling this problem. Okay, based on this, so what are the further meaning of those three assumptions? Assumption one states that the model is correct, implying that yi, if model is correct, imply that yi depends only on xi. This one is xi, and that all other variation in yi is random. Simply, it is just depends upon xi in average, because average of epsilon I, it would be zero, so it depends upon xi only. Assumption two, it says that the variance of epsilon or y doesn't depend on xi, the given observation. It is independent of xi, the variance of epsilon, that error term and the response term, it doesn't depend on xi. You might have already seen that derivation assumption. Okay, that means further we can say that assumption two is also known as the assumption of what, homogeneous variance or constant variance. Simply we can say that third assumption, it says that the epsilon variable are uncorrelated to each other. That means if epsilon is uncorrelated to each other, it implies that corresponding response is also uncorrelated to each other. So that we can see it, that thing we can, so if you are taking variance of epsilon sigma square, then we can calculate from here the variance of yi by using that linear model. Replace yi by replace this epsilon by this linear model we had, yi equal to epsilon omega naught plus omega 1 times x I plus epsilon I. Okay, so replace here this this term by the difference of yi and this term, so that one is coming. So if you simplify further, what you will get, you will see that you will get the variance of yi. Replace it by, so variance of yi is equal to same variance what epsilon I has taken. So that is coming from directly assumption three. Now here question is coming here. We have to do parameter estimation. What are the parameters? So parameter we are having omega naught, omega 1. Also there is one parameter. What is third one? One is omega naught, another one is omega 1. That what is third one, which is very much essential to know in order to understand that linear model. What is that? That sigma square. We don't know the sigma square as well. We have to estimate that value from the given data. So we will have the value of we will have a sample of size n. That means we are having data set with n number of sample. I varies from 1 to n. Another notation you can say it like this way. N number of a sample of size n. From this sample, we try to estimate omega naught, omega 1, and variance, because variance of the error, because we also don't know why we are estimating variance of error, because that is the same variance of the response as well. So that's why, so we need to estimate this as well. So we are having in this simple univariate simple linear regression model, we are having three parameter that we need to estimate. So what, using a random sample of n observation y1 y2 yn up to yn, and along with the fixed value of x, that x1, x2, xn, we can estimate these three parameter, that omega naught, omega 1, and sigma square, that variance of the error. So we seek estimator, what are the omega naught hat, omega naught 1, and s square. Simply you can say the s square is the sample variance of this one, or it depends upon directly we can't say that it is a sample variance. It is an estimate of simply one estimator of the variance. Okay, we can say that. This we will talk later because it is having a different approach to estimate that variance of the model. But these two, that omega naught hat and omega naught 1, we can get it by minimizing the sum of a square of the deviation yi minus yi hat. That means we are introducing that omega naught hat and omega 1 hat, both are estimate of omega naught and omega 1 respectively. So just what we do, we are defining a residual. So you can call it here, this one is the residual ri equal to yi minus yi hat, and from here we will define sum of a square of this residual, okay, and we will minimize those to get set of estimator of omega naught and omega 1. So that's where this is the objective function corresponding we are defining, and you can go further and you can define this is the error function. Okay, and now what you do, you can apply simple calculus technique. So calculus techniques, what does it say? So here you can say that, what is this? This one is a function of, here what is the argument which is varying here? So argument is this omega naught and omega 1. So you can simply say that here it is a function of omega naught on omega 1. That one is the unknown quantity here. So from the calculus, so it is a function of two variables. So apply the criteria of calculus. What you do, you have to find first necessary criteria is that find the gradient of this function of two variables equate to zero, that will give critical points. And later what you do, find the Hessian of this function and see the definiteness of this Hessian. It would be what? It is a matrix 2 by 2. There are two variable, two arguments, so it would be a 2 by 2 matrix. So you have to see the definiteness of this Hessian. If it is a positive definite, then that would leads to minimum of this this objective function. So you have to see, definitely if you try to check it, you will see that it would be what, positive definite. If it is a positive definite, then this error function, sum of a square of residual, it will have minimum value with respect to if you are taking Hessian is positive definite. So from here, if you further simplify the simplified form, it will give the same expression what you had already seen in the case of moment of method, what you call it. So method of moment, so same derivation you will get here. Omega naught hat, it would be just ratio of estimated variance, covariance of x and y with variance of x, and substitute in the linear model by taking mean, you will get estimate of omega naught hat. That omega naught hat you are getting, the same derivation what you are getting. So anyone till now, any question? No. So in next class I will talk about estimation of sigma square, because you need to know something more in order to estimate this one. So before going to estimate sigma square, I will introduce here univariate multiple linear regression. That means we are having multiple attribute. That scenario we are talking. So I will talk about estimation of y for given multiple attribute. So how we can, so one approach would be least square estimation approach, so that I will talk about. So least square approach is giving estimate of y as a conditional expectation. This conditional expectation as an estimator, it is an estimator of y, but how it is coming? It is coming through least square estimation approach. So that's where conditional expectation of y given x, you can say that it is an one estimate of hypothesis function. That means we try to see the dependency between various attribute x1, x2 and the response y. So that dependency we express it like this way. F is a y is a function of x1, x2 up to xn, and we don't know f. One estimate is this conditional expectation. That one is coming thanks to least square estimation technique. So it is one estimation of f of, so we can say like this way. So I will talk that approach. So consider y is statistically related to several random variable x1, x2 up to xn, whose value we have already observed. So that means this attribute we have already observed, the value of those attributes we have already observed. We want to see the dependency of y over these xi's. So how it will depend. So then what approach we will apply? We will go for least mean square estimation approach. That means we try to suppose g of x is one estimator of this y, and we will find square of error, and then after we will find sum, that expectation, simply here call it expectation. Expectation, find the expectation and try to see for which value of g this expectation is the least, for which value that would serve the best estimator for y. So we can check it like this way. So and we are the conditional, we are claiming that the conditional expectation of y for given n number of observation x1, x2, up to xn, the conditional expectation is the best estimator under the least square estimation process, and it is defined like this way. So how we can say that further, that this conditional expectation, you can say that it is the argument of the minimum value of mean square error. So this conditional expectation, you can say that argument of this one, among the several g, this would have the least mean square error. This conditional expectation would have. So we can see it from the derivation of mean square error. How we express mean square error? So mean square error, you can take it like this way. Here it would be simply g, function of g. Don't take it like this. Okay, y minus g. Now what we do here? We add and subtract this conditional expectation of y for given x1, x2 up to xn. We are adding or subtracting, so that's where the situation is coming. And further, if you simplify, you can bifurcate to algebra. Just it is talking about a squaring of two terms. This term, what you can call it, the difference of y with conditional expectation, and this is the difference of conditional expectation with any g. It is any g of x1, x2. It will go up to like this. Xn. Okay, just do a squaring, and after simplification it will be bifurcated into two terms, this term and this term. What is this? This is always non-negative greater than equal to zero. This would be also always non-negative greater than equal to zero. So we can say that the mean square error is bounded above by what? This quantity. Mean square error is bounded above by this quantity. Then that means when you are taking g equal to conditional expectation, then that will provide a lower bound of the error, mean square error. So we can claim from here that this conditional expectation is the best estimator for this problem. Okay, in next class I will talk about derivation of that, those things. Derivation for computation of the parameter involved in this multiple univariate linear model. Regarding attendance, just mark your attendance there in the comment.